Hey guys, what's up? This is JBaller88 for CardRunners.com. I'm making a 2-4 and 3-6 video right now, a live video. I'm gonna fold here, I guess. Pocket 4 is under the gun. Here I'm gonna go ahead and open. And this board decided to check back the King Jack against a weaker player. Don't think we get a ton of value. I think we get some leads. I think if he bets, he'll bet call ace high. We happen to turn two pair there. Otherwise, we're going to call. Here, we are probably just going to fold. Squeeze, cold call. Really not interested in messing around. It seems like the cold calls in Bovada are fairly strong, so I'm just going to go ahead and fold king 8 here. If it was suited or king 9 suited, I might consider calling along. But just not king it off. Not going to bluff with it. Not going to do anything with it. Here's a miniseries from the cutoff and a call. I'm definitely going to just go ahead and squeeze here. Fighting is interesting, but I think squeezing is probably just better. Just take down the dead money. People seem to play poorly in 3-bet pots. People don't seem to like slow play many big hands in these spots. So, I'm not really too worried about that as it would be on like other sites. So we get a call here. I think his range is most likely similar hands to ours, possibly like a pocket eights type hand, pocket sevens, pocket nines, something like that. Maybe pocket tens, but either way, we're just three barreling this board. If he raises, we're probably just jamming here. Don't really think he'll raise if he was slow playing preflop. Just gonna open ace jack here. Just going to bet a little less than half pot here, and then set up the 3-barrel, so we have fold equity on the river. Expect to get a fold or raise pretty often. If he calls, it's most likely that he has a pocket pair that's trying to get the showdown, so we're going to barrel. Expect to get a fold most of the time, though. But it's always good to be prepared, you know, for all the possible options. Here he's ISOing a poster limper, didn't notice, but I'm going to definitely 3-bet him. Even though we're a little deep, it's probably still just a profitable 3-bet. I think flatting out of position is okay too, but I think we're going to make it 109 because we're a little bit deeper. Going to fold here. Just going to fold here. If he calls, we're just going to play pretty cautiously. At least if he calls, we're unlikely to be dominated unless he is exactly like ace-queen. I don't expect to be 4-bet that often. Obviously, we get a great flop, so we're going to go ahead and barrel this board. His calling range in the sport, you could have 10s, 8s, Stoudy is king 10. Definitely going to go ahead and c-bet to get value from his gutters and stuff like that. Probably checking a turn most of the time. Probably betting about, I think about 130 is about right. And here, definitely going to steal. Some reason I opened a 9 instead of 8. I just like doing that to keep me more involved in the hands. We get jammed on here. I am definitely folding here. I just don't see many people bluffing in this spot. Like, it's a decent spot to bluff in, but I don't know. I mean, I feel like he either somehow flatted ace-king, which I thought was unlikely, or flopped a set and it's playing it really fast, hoping we have something. Possibly slow played aces, but unlikely. Either way, I just don't think we beat enough. Like, ace-jack has what? How much equity? 3 outs, and then the queen out, so 6 outs, so we have about, you know, 75-25 against that. I think it is more combos of sets, possibly 2 pairs than ace-jack, jack-9 type hands anyway, so it's just a fold. So, it's pretty standard hand, I would assume. In the turn we were planning, if it was a brick, check back, call, probably call the river most of the time, try and rep something like jacks or queens or something like that. There would be a good spot for us to bluff in when you do flat 3-bets. It's unlikely for people to flop hands on a king-high board just because people's flatting ranges. So, it's a good thought to think about. Let's see, here we're just opening small blind. Opening nearly any 2 here. This opening here, I don't open all ace-x suiteds under the gun. I open them at most tables. But, you know, if there's loose, passive players, I tend to fold them. If there's very loose, aggressive, good players seeming, I tend to fold them. But at standard tables, I think they're just fine.